So this is it. It's been great working with you.
Pleasure. It was fun.
4 weeks of non-stop
togetherness.
Mm-hmm. All day, every day,
every minute.
I've really enjoyed it.
I had a good time. I learned a lot.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Like what?
That I just have to, you know, accept the fact that my pace of talking is not going to cut it.
What do you mean?
I have to speed up my way of talking if I don't want to be interrupted every 2 seconds.
Wow, you're going to run with that, huh?
Look, we have evidence, about 20 episodes of evidence on tape.
Listen,
you interrupted me probably like 30 times, 40 times, 50 times, at least.
What does that have to do with anything? It doesn't matter if she interrupts you.
Yes, it does matter if she interrupts me. Would you like if I interrupted you every time you open your mouth, Sophie?
Not every time.
Well, there you go.
She doesn't do it every time either.
All I'm saying is that I've accepted it, so.
Exactly. It's just a natural way of talking, Boris.
If you accepted it, then why do you keep talking about it?
Woo! Woo-hoo-hoo! Clap back!
Today for you. Iyanla, Vanzant is here.
And we have the super talented and happily married dancing couple, Steven Twitch Boss and Allison Holker, joining us.
Plus, you do not want to miss wedding planner extraordinaire David Tatera is here.
But before we get into all that, you know how we like to talk about the trending topics at the beginning of the show. Well, today we thought we'd bring out someone who is very opinionated to join us in the discussion. Please put your hands together for Margaret Cho!
Margaret! Welcome.
Thank you so much.
All right. Well, first, we want to talk about, everybody's heard of what happened. It's the senseless killing of Cecil the Lion.
Yeah.
Now, Margaret, like a lot of people, I know you tweeted about it. What's your opinion on this?
Well, I'm so sad about this. I mean, this lion, this magnificent creature, we don't have a lot of them left. And he is in this protected environment. And, you know, when you dismantle a pride like that, see, because he has cubs, mm-hmm. The dominant male there is going to kill the cubs. It's actually a very destructive thing when you take out one of the members of this community. And it's an outrage. What is very funny is that the murderer is actually a dentist.
Walter Palmer.
And he had a Yelp page. And so all of our anger got to be directed at this Yelp page, which is a kind of justice, but it's not going to bring this magnificent creature back. We've got to treat the earth with much more respect than this. I mean, I don't know what he was thinking.
Yeah. Well, he was saying,
so
he was saying he hunts legally and responsibly. Like that one time he pleaded guilty for illegally killing a black bear in Wisconsin, for instance. And what's so outrageous is that they justify it by saying, well, these big game hunter justify their actions by saying that them paying money to legally hunt with the permission of authorities actually helps the preservation of endangered species, which is basically like saying, I kill rhinos to keep rhinos from being killed. Which makes no sense.
It doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't make any sense.
Well, what was so wrong about it really was from top to bottom, they lured him out of the park. The park is designed to protect the animals. They lured him out, wounded him, waited 40 hours for him to die, and then beheaded and skinned him.
Yeah.
I mean, there's somewhere in that process, there's something that has to click in and say, maybe I shouldn't be doing this. But some people just don't have that personal empathy.
I mean, as human beings, we are responsible for all creatures on this earth. You know, we 100%. Are here to care for the planet. We've done a lot of damage to it, and unfortunately, it should be illegal. I don't understand why he's trying to say he justified paying this money. It would be illegal to kill this lion. Also, why do it in such a sadistic and disgusting way?
Yeah.
I mean, what's the point of that? Why does this? I mean, he is a dentist, so I don't know. I'm in a lot of grief about this creature. Yes. And
we were just on safari for the first time with our children, and they got to see these animals up close, not in a zoo environment. I mean, you haven't seen an elephant in the wild. I mean, there's nothing like the one in the zoo.
No.
The giraffe, they're healthy, they're beautiful, they're being taken care of.
They're not suffering from OCD, which is oftentimes what happens with animals who are in, you know, in zoos.
Captivity, yeah.
Yeah, that's a beautiful thing that you got to see. Yeah.
Nature tourism, Walter Palmer, that's a way to support endangered species, not kill them.
Yeah.
Well, on another person, who's been in the news, we have to talk about this self-proclaimed fitness motivator. His name is John Burke, who posted a video rant which has gone viral. Did you guys see that?
Well, some people find his comments motivational and others find it very offensive. Let's take a look at this clip and you can decide for yourself.
It is not okay to be overweight. Yes, I will attack society's view of saying we should accept everybody for who they are. They're absolutely right. We should. But when I sit there and I look at somebody that's overweight, no, I find that utterly repulsive and disgusting. Why? Because it shows a lack of self-discipline.
Okay, well, Margaret, you're known for your activism and for taking a tough stand on issues. What do you think about this type?
I think everybody should be healthy. You know, I think people should work out. I don't, but they should. And, you know, it's not a judgment on anybody if they're... I always think, you know, people are overweight, underweight. It doesn't really matter. Your body's your body because you're in your body. It's not a judgment on you. Your body isn't something to be judged. It just is. But he makes a living out of doing this. Maybe he makes people feel better who want to be thinner, who want to be stronger, who want to be fitter. I think he's just trying to be empathetic, but real angry about it.
And, yeah.
He went on to say, it's sheer laziness, too lazy to cook a meal, requires some effort on your part to get up there and take an active role in your children's life. He says, then you wonder why your children get made fun of at school when they're fat. So he's very, very outspoken and very verbal about this.
Somebody probably pushed him into shape by talking to him that way.
Yeah.
So he believes he's being effective. Yeah. I personally like the tough love approach because I really am unmotivated, so it does push me to do my best. Mm-hmm. But I just think the generalization is wrong. You don't know why people are the way they are. What if they have a medical condition? Or what if they're medicating themselves with the food? You don't know what someone's been through. And you always have to back off those judgments, those generalizations.
Well, yeah. And I'm just straight up lazy and I don't care. Like, I don't care. That's fine.
Yeah.
Well, that's fun for me.
And our health issues are one thing, and we know the data. We know that we're not healthy. But again, it's up to the individual to do what they want to do.
Yeah.
You know, it's not up to us to judge them. My wife always says this very eloquently. She says, you know, you don't know where they have been and where they are on their journey. Ooh. They might have just lost 40 pounds, you know. They might be feeling good about themselves right now. So you have to be kind, you have to be encouraging, you have to be compassionate about where they are in their journey. Now everybody, and everybody, you guys have to remember that you are the star of your own movie. Don't look to the right, don't look to the left, don't worry about the TV and social media and what the people are doing on TV. You are the star of your own movie, and your script is being written as we speak. You have to walk your path at your own pace.
That's right.
And you have to be comfortable with who you are.
Well, Margaret, We love having you here. I hope you come back.
Thank you. I would love to.
You have an opening.
Give it up for Margaret Cho, everybody.
Before you leave, I want you to tell everyone about your upcoming tour.
I'm going on tour. I'm going all over the world. It starts in Detroit on October 1st, and it will go everywhere all over Europe. It's called There's No I in Team, but There's a Cho in Psycho.
Nice.
That's my show.
Thank you, Margaret.
Thank you.
We have to take a break, but before we go, we want to give a shout out to all the athletes at the Special Olympics World Games.
That's right.
Thank you
for being here. Go check them out.
The
closing
ceremony
else, guys.
Will be this Sunday. I think my husband's interrupting me just a little bit.
Our guest is known for changing lives. She's a 5-time New York Times best-selling author and one of America's most profound spiritual leaders. Please welcome the host and executive producer of Iyanla, Fix My Life, Iyanla Vanzant!
Before we say anything else, I just want you to know, sister to sister, I love your husband.
Me too.
Now it's
I
out
love
there.
Too.
We don't have nothing but
time. Well, I like that how you just come out and
I just wanted
honest.
Her to know, because we've hugged in airports and hallways.
Yes.
We've been at hotels together.
Yes.
I just want you to have the full scoop. Of what's going
our
on.
Our relationship history.
Yes.
How
are you?
We're good.
Oh, you're supposed to ask me that. I'm sorry.
That's right. You're on the other side of the couch now, sis. So it's such a pleasure to have you
Thank
here.
Thank you. My pleasure to be
yes.
here. Wish you the best of luck. It's really been, I've been watching.
Thank
I'm a fan.
You.
Oh,
thank you.
And I was wondering if I was going to get a cup when I got
there
here.
You
I
go.
Told you the mug is very important.
The mug.
Yes.
Yeah.
Did you get mugs on your show?
Yeah.
You
yes.
got another?
Yeah. My guests get their mug before they get there. They get a mug and a journal. Hey.
Wow. Well, this is just first season for us.
Okay.
So bear
right,
with us.
Right. But see, but my guests have work to do. Your guests have fun to have.
Yes,
there's a distinction.
That's right.
Well, let's get right into it. Now,
okay.
Some people don't know, your birth name was Rhonda Harris.
Yes.
And you changed
Rhonda Eva Harris. Let's have it
yes,
all.
Yes, the whole thing there. And you changed it to Iyanla.
Yes, it was changed when I went through, I would say, a spiritual training and initiation. Mm-hmm. And, you know, your name is your nature. So when people call your name, they are really encouraging and educating your spirit about who you are. And I was no longer Rhonda. And I went through this powerful initiation, and my name was changed to Iyanla, which means great mother. And you know, the mother is the teacher and the guide. The mother nourishes and nurtures. And that's really what I intend to do with my work, is teach and educate and nurture.
That's amazing.
Thank you. Well, my name means victorious. Nicole is victorious, and Ari means, is Hebrew for lion. So I'm a victorious lion.
All right.
Hello.
So I'm set.
Well, my name, Kodjoe, means Monday. So,
Monday?
Yes.
Oh, that's right. Kodjoe means Monday.
That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Born on Monday.
Boris Monday.
Because
Mr. Monday.
In that tradition, my name would be Okosua. Which
Okosua,
is born
yeah.
on Sunday.
Sunday, that's
yeah.
right.
And I'm Akua, which is born on Wednesday.
Well, there
well,
you
well,
go.
Well, now we cleared it all up. Now, here's another thing that most people don't know about you.
Yeah.
You used to be a lawyer.
Yes, I'm still a
well,
lawyer.
Well, you are still, oh, of course, you're
practice.
Still a lawyer.
Yeah, criminal law. I was going to be the black female Perry Mason.
Wow. So, you having been an attorney, is that a reason why you're so in love with shows like Law & Order?
See,
I'm not in love with Law & Order. I'm in love with Jack McCoy. I like Law & Order,
well,
but I
fellow,
watch Jack
you have
McCoy.
A fellow Law & Order crazed
The original is
here.
The best, right?
I know.
Love it.
I just
don't know what it is. And, you know, I know.
It's a problem in our marriage.
Really?
It's become a problem.
Yes.
Why?
Because
I'm like
Jack. At 10
He's
o'clock,
jealous of
at
Jack.
At 10 o'clock at night, when the kids are asleep, you know, I want to get a little closer. And all I hear is, in the criminal justice system.
You've seen this episode 20 times already.
I haven't seen this one.
No, me too. I say the same thing. It's a lie.
Of course it's a lie.
I've seen them all. But you know what Gail King gave me for a present a couple of years ago? The entire, are you ready? Clutch of Pearls. The entire seasons, all of them.
Wow.
Was it like 30 of them? Back.
Yes, yes.
Wow. Oh, I'm so coming over your house.
But you know, no. I don't play those. I don't play those.
You save them?
Yes, I save them.
You don't take them out for guests?
No.
They're for binge-a-thon.
Why should I? There's always some jackets on every station at some time or another.
Well, you know, you're also very crafty, arts and crafts. You make scrapbooks, you make soaps and candles and cards. How did you get into that?
Well, you know, Masterpiece, the line of Masterpiece, that's not a soap, it's a body wash. There's a difference because it clears your energy as it cleans your body. Wow. And it was really started by my daughter, Jamia, before she made transition. Her life was surrendered to colon cancer when she was 31. Mm. And this line she started, and I've revived it really as her legacy, because she was a master aromatherapist. I'm an herbalist, she was an aromatherapist. And so we combine herbs and oils in a way that clears your energy. Because you know, sometimes people just have nasty energy.
Oh,
do y'all
absolutely.
Know that? Have you ever just seen somebody and said, ew? Well, now you can hand them a bottle of Masterpiece.
You can
wash
clean
with this.
On the inside and the outside.
Right. And it's made with African black soap. And the thing about Masterpiece is I make it. I make every bottle by hand myself. I pray over it. I cure it. And I treat it with water, healing, music. Mm-hmm. And I do that while I'm watching Law and Order. And I recommend for single ladies, purification and then Sweet Attraction.
Ooh, I like that. But I'm not single. I'm happily married.
But you got friends, right? You got friends.
Okay.
She wants it for her friends.
We have to take a break.
Good saying.
But when we return, someone in the audience has a question and she wants an answer, Iyanla style. We'll be right back. Vanzant, Iyanla, your new season of your show, Fix My Life, airs in September. Yes. Do you feel like the fixes are getting tougher?
I don't think the fixes are getting tougher. Every fix is the same. People need to know that they matter and that they're loved. That's really all it is. Mm. What's happening is people know that I'm coming. So I think they're getting a little more resistant, a little more savvy. Mm. You know, they're like, oh, she ain't gonna get me.
But you still have that magic way of getting to the bottom of the issue and having a breakthrough. We have a clip.
Yeah, we have a clip from your upcoming season. Let's roll it.
Tell the truth about what you did. Tell the truth about what you did.
No,
speak on your own pain. And that is what gives people permission to stand in theirs. The truth will set you free. You think this is your business? This is God's business.
That's really powerful advice. We have Greta in our audience, and she needs some advice from you, too, and she has a question. Come on down, Greta. Welcome.
Thank you. Welcome, Greta. Have a seat.
Hello. I'm scared after seeing that.
Have a seat, please.
Hi.
Nice to
meet you.
Yes. So what's your question, Greta?
My question is how to say no. I don't know how to tell people no. I get taken advantage of over and over, and it's not pretty.
Well, how's that working for you?
It's not working.
Well, it must be because you keep doing it. We only do what works. We only do what works. So I heard you say you can't say no. Is that true?
That's so true.
No, say no.
No.
No. And another way.
No way.
Another way. Say no
say
in another
no
way.
Say no in another way. That's why I'm sitting here.
I tell people that you've got to build your no muscle. And you only can build your no muscle when you know that you are as important as everybody else. No is the only word in the language that doesn't require an explanation. So what you have to do is you have to come up with 101 ways to say no. No.
Wow.
Nope. No. No. No, baby, no. Practice saying no. Let me hear you. No. That's one way. Give me another way.
I like the nope.
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 There you go.
No way, Jose.
Right? Okay. Come on, see, you're getting good at it already. Just keep practicing.
Nine.
Yeah.
Nine.
And you know the famous one.
Bite me.
Oh, bite you. We don't do that kinky kind of stuff.
Wrong.
Oh, hell to the no.
Oh, yeah.
You know
that
one.
There you go.
Right? Build your no muscle by reminding yourself that you are as important as everyone else. And for the next 7 days, no matter what anybody says to you, just say no. Just say no and come up with your 101 ways. How are you?
No.
Are you a girl?
Nope.
Wait a minute.
Yeah. Just say no.
Just say no.
Greta, what do you think of Iyanla's advice?
I love it, but yeah, there's kind of more to the story, but what you have to say makes sense, and I will practice it.
Stop telling the story.
No.
Stop telling the story.
Oh, there's
she
more.
Said, no, that was good.
That's
but that wasn't
good.
A question. Stop telling the story. Next 3 days, I don't care what people say. You want to go to lunch?
No.
Does your head hurt?
No.
Do your feet hurt?
No.
Is your name Greta?
Nope.
Fantastic.
I like it.
Thank you so much, Greta. And special thanks to Iyanla Vanzant. Be sure to get Iyanla's most recent book, Forgiveness, which is available now.
Also, starting in September, be sure to catch the new season of Iyanla Fix My Life, Saturdays on OWN.
Yeah. Yes. Woo! Up next, a summer wedding fashion show that you don't want to miss. As you know, and you also know what that means. It's wedding season! Yes! From the ring bearer to the dream gown, every bride wants her special day full of perfect memories. So here with the latest fashion trends and celebrity weddings is style guru and designer and the host of David Tutera Celebrations. Please welcome David Tutera.
Thank you.
What is your secret to, like, the fabulous summer wedding style?
Well, staying cool. Yeah. It's a little hot out here.
It's still July.
You need to embrace where you are, the season of the venue, light fabrics, keeping your guests very comfortable, and still making sure it's sophisticated and elegant. So there's so many things you can do during the summer months. I'm just sort of curious. You got married 10 years ago, right?
Yes.
What month was it?
It was in May.
So was it warm?
It was.
You look beautiful. I looked at all the photos, by the way.
Yeah.
I did my homework. Come on.
I love that. And I did have a very, my gown was actually cotton.
It was beautiful.
It was from
off
Belgium.
The shoulder,
yes.
Drop sweetheart neckline.
Yep.
And excuse me, but your husband had a cream suit on.
I know.
Which is so on trend 10 years ago, which is spectacular.
He looked great. So that's why I married him.
Well, because of the cuffs?
No.
I think you've got a lot more reasons than just the
tux. No, because he was just hot.
We're not going to disagree. I'm not going to disagree.
Well, David, let's check out the fashion. What's the fresh style for the bridesmaids?
Well, you know, it's all about making sure your bridesmaids are incredibly comfortable, and it's all about color. So we're going to take a look right now at Monique, which is wearing a design by Annie Sokola from Anna Elise Collections.
This is so elegant,
but yet light, and also the color is on trend. It's apricot. We're seeing a lot of soft pastels, but bumped up a little bit in the color tones. And if you turn around, you can see the sweetheart neckline in the front, a very modest back line. And this is a great silhouette on all bridesmaids. And bridesmaids can wear short, long, and multiple colors.
You could even cut this later and have a sweet summer dress.
If she cuts that right above the knee about 2 to 3 inches, she's got a great look far beyond just the walk down the aisle.
Great. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
You look gorgeous.
Now, we all know the flower girl and the ring bearer steal the show. So what's the new trends to come for them?
Well, yeah, they steal the show. The little kids steal the show. And we're going to take a look at Anissa and Joseph, and they're in looks by Annie Girl Couture Creations.
Oh,
and you know, here's what I love to do. First of all, Joseph and Anissa, you look absolutely adorable. It's not about throwing the petals or carrying the pillow.
Anissa, can we see your dress? Oh, wow.
move your little sign. Let's see your dress.
How cute, right?
Shoes too, sweetheart.
And Nicole, you know what I'm doing is I'm actually putting the smaller ones, like the flower girl and the ring bearer, at the head of the processional before any of the bridal party comes out. Uh-huh. So it doesn't take the thunder away from the moment the bride has.
Yes. Well, thank you
guys. You guys look
so
cute. Thank you so much.
I love his pink vest and bow tie.
I know, that pop of color is really adorable. Thank you guys.
Well, let's look at the groom. The groom always gets kicked to the curb. Let's see how fabulous we can make our groom.
Whoa! Wow! Nathan, I need a little help because Nathan is wearing my line, my David Tutera men's collection. And you know, the guys never know what to do.
That's what I'm saying.
You know,
what
I want Nathan,
how can they spruce it up a little?
Watch the pop in his sock from my line.
Hey! Then, now that's hot.
Look, I got it. I got it right here.
I need to get some of those.
And then I added the pop of color into his pocket square. So they have a little personality. They need a little pizzazz,
What's
the guys.
What's going on with this beautiful lapel? Is there a little detail
yes,
on the lapel?
Yes, the lapel has an inset, beautiful tuxedo line. It's adding a touch of detail because, again, the guys are always slighted. There's never this excitement. So this is a great way to add color.
And you put the bow tie under the collar.
Yes.
I love it. Thank you, Nathan.
Thanks, Nathan.
And now for the moment we've been waiting for, here comes the bride. Wow. So tell us about this gorgeous look.
Kendra is wearing my line, David Tutera from Mon Cherie, and it's all about the sophistication and elegance with a touch of old Hollywood. We're still seeing lace, and in the summer, this is a light fabric. It's got a slight plunging back line with a beautiful, modest sweetheart neckline. This is a great way to take the summer month. I'm so hot right now that I know I'm wearing that, I probably would be more comfortable. But it's all about the details. You'll see the appliques from the sweetheart neckline right down to the hemline.
Yes.
A sophisticated approach to whether you're in a barn, a beach, a ballroom, wherever the venue might be.
It's gorgeous, it's gorgeous. Thank you so much. Let's bring out our entire wedding party back out here. You know, you can use your pocket square
To dab, right?
Can you do that for me? Yes, I can.
Oh, see, I'm so hot, I need help.
We help each other out
Thank
here
so
on
much.
The Boris and Nicole Show. Ooh. Look at these gorgeous people.
Thank you.
You know, sometimes planning your dream wedding can feel like a nightmare. Iyanla and Dave have dreams of a beautiful wedding. There are guests in the audience today, but they've run into some roadblocks. Come on up here, Iyanla and Dave. Now, welcome. Ivana, you've been engaged. You're a beautiful couple, by the way.
Thank
Aren't
you.
They beautiful? Engaged for 6 months, and you want to get married soon, but you're not able to. So tell us why.
We moved here about a year ago, and I've just been promised a lot of job opportunities. That was one of the reasons I moved here, and they keep getting pulled from under me. So with our engagement and trying to plan the wedding, it's been a huge struggle because, you know, things keep falling through, so that's puts a big damper in it.
Dave, how does this making you feel?
It's a little hard to deal with.
Yeah. But you know what? In Hollywood, dreams can come true. Yes. So just side piece of advice, you keep going and you hold on to each other and you don't give up, okay?
Okay.
I'm telling you because I know. It really does happen, okay? Well, we understand how stressful everything is and how hard it is to plan a wedding. And thanks to David Tutera, you're both going home with items from his collection. Yes, yes, yes. You're getting the wedding gown, the tuxedo, the shoes, the socks, and the jewelry. But that's not all. Every couple has dreams of going on a romantic honeymoon, and we want you to have the same. Boris and I are sending you on a 4-night, 5-day, all-inclusive honeymoon stay at the St. James's Club, Morgan Bay in St. Lucia! This property has accommodations, activities, and amenities perfect for a relaxing getaway. St. Lucia is recognized as a top honeymoon destination. The island is home to rainforests and one of the world's few drive-in volcanoes. Thank you to Elites Island Resorts and the St. Lucia Tourism Board. For more information, log on to BorisandNicole.com. Thank you to David Tutera for these fabulous summer wedding styles. We'll be right back.
guests are a dynamic dancing duo from two of our favorite dance shows, So You Think You Can Dance and Dancing with the Stars. Woo! Please welcome husband and wife team, Steven Twitch Boss and Allison Holker. Young people in the audience today and backstage, and everybody's going crazy that you two are here.
That's awesome.
Yes,
that's
awesome.
Very good to be here. There's also a lot of not so young ladies in the audience who are going crazy over you and Magic Mike.
Okay.
Remember Magic Mike?
That's right.
So, how did you two meet?
Okay, you want to take it, baby?
Yeah, I'll take this.
Is it two different versions? Is that strong?
Yeah,
her version
kinda.
Is better. Okay. Always.
Yeah. It's the strong one.
It's the strong one.
So we were both all-stars on So You Think You Can Dance, yes. Season 7. And I had a crush on him from the moment I met him. I mean, First off, look at him. He's super sexy, super good looking. But then he's also like the most genuine guy ever. He's so nice. So me being, you know, what I thought was a flirt, I tried putting the moves on him. And I was always trying to be like, you know, close to him or near him or kind of like touching his arm. Mm. And apparently he wasn't getting the vibe. He was not understanding at all. He had no idea.
All,
so I just kept trying to like put those moves out there, which also shows that I'm not really a good flirt. But then we were at the wrap party and he looked at me from the bar and kind of did this like motion of his finger, like, come here.
So he was drunk? Is that what you said?
No, not yet. What was crazy, I know, right? But this is the only time, literally, okay, because let me be honest here, okay? I have no game whatsoever, which is why I probably didn't pick up on the signs, you know? I just wasn't reading. Mm-hmm. But this is the only time this has worked. I saw her coming down the stairs. I was at the bar. I pointed at her, the right song was playing. I pointed at her, did a little come here situation. We danced the whole night, and we've been together since.
No way.
Wow.
Yeah. It's kind of crazy.
It's
so funny, because that's exactly what I did with her.
You did too?
Really?
And then Chris said, and I pointed at her and said, come here, baby.
Come here. And then that dance, yep.
No, it didn't work.
And sadly enough, it really did work, I have to say.
Do you guys have so much fun together? Like, are you like dancing and happy and music playing at home? Like,
We really do.
How did you get a name like Twitch?
Well, the style of dance that I studied named popping is a contraction of the muscles. When I practice that, I practice it everywhere, like school and church and all that. And to the untrained eye, it looks like a twitch, and it kind of stuck. So,
wow.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Do that again.
Oh, I know you got it. You be at the gym, bro.
Yeah,
I know
you.
Exactly. So there you go.
That's it. No.
You already got it. That's it.
Yeah, not at all.
Well, Allison, you're a pro dancer on Dancing with the Stars, and you're also the only married pro dancer and the only mom, too.
Yeah.
How do you balance everything?
You know, it honestly, I think I have to remember as a mother and a wife and as a professional worker that it's never going to be perfect. You're never going to feel like you've found that perfect balance. And you have to accept that. You have to do your best every single day, give everyone the attention that they deserve, and go with like a smile on your face, and just do the best that you can, because you can't, you're never going to be perfect. And you have to remember that as a woman, that it's always going to be hard. You're always going to question if you're doing the right thing at that moment, but you have to believe that you are trying your best.
Yeah. And that you're good enough.
Yeah, yes. And that you're good enough.
And that's amazing you say that, because we struggle with that all the time.
Yeah.
You know, we have 20 balls in the air at the same time. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you just have to be okay with dropping one or two balls every once in a while, right?
Yes.
Absolutely.
And it's also the support system. Like, I have this amazing husband that is so patient with us and is always there for us whenever I need him. So he helps out so much, which is just incredible, and I'm so grateful for that.
Wow, she's propping you up like
this. I know, that's what I'm saying. It's called marrying up, you know what I mean? It's
like, you know, like, everyone thinks you're miserable, we don't dance, you don't want the kids, we give you your props. Ladies, don't I always give him his props? Yes.
Yeah, you do.
I'm just kidding.
It's about that, though, you know?
I like that.
You guys are also the co-founders of CLI Online Dance Studios.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Tell us about this program.
Well, you know, dance training is very specific. Professional dance training is very specific towards Los Angeles, New York, Chicago. You're really metropolitan areas. So it's been hard for, you know, middle America and places in other countries that don't travel here to take class, to get classes from world-renowned choreographers and quality dance education. So CLI actually makes the dance world a little smaller. So anybody from any studio anywhere, anybody wanting to just dance in their living room, can go to CLIStudios.com and take class from us, from working professionals in the industry.
Yeah, but it's really, it's marketed towards any age group, any shape, size, any beginning, advanced, intermediate, any kind of level of dance. If you're someone that used to dance and you want to get back into it, or you want to use it for fitness, there's so many different avenues for this. So we're just kind of branching it out and making it online available to everyone.
Were you guys dancing as kids?
I did. I started dancing when I was 11. So my sister was a dancer, and I kind of saw her dancing one time, and I was really inspired by it. So that's when I started.
Yeah. So Twitch, you're currently a team captain on So You Think You Can Dance.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. Yeah.
And the competition's heating up.
Yes, it is.
This season with street dance versus stage dance. Now you are captain of the street dance team,
I am.
Right?
I am. Absolutely.
Let's take a look.
Be sure to watch Twitch on So You Think You Can Dance Mondays on Fox, and see Allison on Dancing with the Stars.
Keep the sexy challenge reveal is next. Don't go away.
Welcome back. A few weeks ago, we launched our Keep It Sexy Challenge with Dorothy and Raphael, a couple on a mission to get healthy, lose weight, and keep it sexy for each other. Take a look.
Andrea is going to design your own four-week Keep It Sexy Challenge.
Yeah.
We're going to follow Dorothy and Raphael's progress over the next 4 weeks.
Day one of our Keep It Sexy Challenge. We're about to head into the gym for the first time.
You know it.
A little nervous, but we'll see how it goes.
We just finished our workout. Our couple did amazing. They're well on their way.
Little tiny changes that support your goals in the ways of like what you eat, how often you eat, how much you eat. When you add that nutrition to the activity, you really start to see changes pretty fast.
Okay, here we are, working out still. Doing our thing, keeping it sexy.
Joining us now is the fitness trainer who helps Dorothy and Raphael, Andrea Orbeck.
Hey, Andrea. Now, before we see their results, what was Dorothy and Raphael's biggest challenge during the past 4 weeks?
It was scheduling. Not unlike most families and couples. Wow. He worked nights, she worked days. Tough to get it together, but they ended up working out every single day despite it.
How did they make that happen?
I think that they just agreed that they were going to make the time. It's a bit of sacrifice. Days he was tired, or they did it late at night before he went off to work. Mm-hmm. They just found the time to do it, and
that's
it happened.
Wow. Yeah. Well, during our fitness challenge, you posted tips to our Facebook page. What response did you get from other couples that saw it?
You know, I was surprised that most couples don't work out together, and I think that this gave them the incentive to rally together as a team. The reason why we did Keep It Sexy was to do exactly that as a couple. And so a lot of people came in saying, I've inspired my wife or my husband to start doing with me. So it was fun to see the results.
That's amazing.
Well, I can't wait any longer. Let's see them before.
Okay, are you ready?
Let's see their four-week Keep It Sexy results. Come on out, Dorothy and Raphael. You guys look great.
You look amazing.
Dorothy.
Yes, give it up.
Dorothy, how do you feel?
I feel amazing, and I'm really proud of us, because like Andrea said, it was crazy scheduling, and we totally pushed through it, and it was so awesome. I feel great.
Raphael, before you took the challenge, you weren't able to make time to work out. What has changed? How did you make that commitment?
Well, also, as Andrea said, we were kind of like, all right, we got to get this done. Let's do this and just make it happen, especially
just
this
get
guy.
Up and do it.
Yeah.
That's it.
Now, you guys told us a lot about the realities of what you eat. You know, there's some beer nights and some chips nights. Was it hard to let go of some of that food?
No.
Very.
Yes.
But you did it. You just
especially
did
beer.
It. Especially the beer. Yeah. But
just,
you know, you let.
Just threw everything away, so I wouldn't go. I'm the culprit. I'm the one who eats it, you know, drinks it. So she just threw it away. I didn't see it. Out of sight, out of mind. Well,
so are you going to continue this lifestyle?
Yes.
Or what do you think?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Thank yes. you. Yes. Thank you guys for making it possible.
Oh, thank you for coming on. This is amazing.
As a trainer, what have you seen? How have they transformed?
Well, you know what I love? My favorite part was that we called it Keep It Sexy, and I always thought, you know, would that really happen? And I noticed a lot of flirtationship. So there was, like, circuit training, a little pat on the bum as they were going to the next station.
Hey, you
blame me? Wow. Well, how has this experience changed your relationship?
Well, we've definitely gotten a lot closer, wink, wink. Yeah.
Well, you know what? It's added more spice.
Yes. Yeah. You look good. Great. You feel good. Aww. Hey, how much did you lose, if I may ask?
Well, I lost 23, and this guy lost 25, so almost 50 pounds.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
After all of your hard work, we think you deserve to treat yourself.
Oh, wow.
So we are sending you on a two-night getaway at Napa Valley's newest boutique hotel, Senza.
Oh, my God.
In the heart of wine country. Now, the spot is owned by Craig and Catherine Hall, who also own Hall Wines. So you will also get a tour and wine tasting at Hall St. Helena.
But not don't drink so much wine, just a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit.
We're still working
out.
So awesome. Slowly. Thank you so much. So, I'm so excited.
Oh you're so
I've never been to Napa, so here we go.
Congratulations.
Yay. Well, we also want to thank the hairstylist, Rebecca Friedman from Good Form Salon in Los Angeles, for giving them your fresh new look, Dorothy and Raphael. And to support you on the next leg of your fitness journey, I'm sending you home with my line of workout sweatbands, the Save Your Dude Gym Wraps. Yes. And audience, I'm not leaving you guys out either because you're all going home with gym wraps. And for viewers at home, visit our Facebook page on log on to BorisandNicole.com, type in the code BN20, and you'll get a discount on the wrap. Celebrity trainer Andrea Orbeck. We'll be right back.
That's going to do it for us. Thanks to our guest, Margaret Cho, Iyanla Vanzant, wedding style expert David Chater, Stephen Twitch Boss, and his lovely wife, Allison Holker. And thanks to fitness trainer Andrea Orbeck and our Keep It Sexy Challenge couple, Dorothy and Raphael.
And thank you to Jackson Limousine for providing car service. And a very, very special thanks to all of you for watching us this month. We hope you enjoyed it as much as we did.
We'll see you soon. Hashtag see you next summer.
Hashtag we'll be right back.
Hashtag Boris and Nicole love you.
Hashtag keep it sexy.
Hashtag you're sexy.
Hashtag hey Nicole.
Hashtag we out.